this situation, we want to work out where the duplicate entries are. Now, for ease of reference, I've already highlighted them in yellow, but let's pretend we don't know that. The problem is that a duplicate is where the salesperson code, the date, product A, product B, and product C sales are the same. We can use the COUNTIF, but it's not very easy to then look across all of these. So a simple way to get around that is to create a unique lookup reference. So in this case, what I'm going to do, I'm going to make use of a function called concatenate. And all we're going to do is we're going to combine the columns that need to be unique. So it's going to be that with that with that. So what we've created now, I'm going to copy it down, is a single column that combines all of these. It's now possible to create a formula that checks whether this is duplicated anywhere else. Because if that is the case, then this must be a true duplicate. So we can use our COUNTIF formula again. And in this case, we're going to tell Excel, please look at this range here, our new column, put the dollar signs on. And what must it look for? Well, it must look for that cell there when it's over here. And as we copy it down, it'll move down. When I say OK, you'll see it says 11. I'm going to copy it down. And notice that it tells us where all the duplicates are. So not only the ones we've highlighted, but notice there's quite a few here. If you look at them, they are exactly the same. So by using a concatenate, you can take multiple columns, turn them into one column, which we can then use to write formulas against.